Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to take a screenshot on your Mac, whether you have like a MacBook Pro or Air laptop or an iMac desktop. All right, let's get started. Okay, so I'm going to show you three ways to do this. And first is the most common way that people use. So this is Shift Command 4. So on your keyboard, hold down Shift Command and the number 4 all at the same time. You'll get this little target, and then you can just take a screenshot of whatever you click and drag a box around like this. And when you release, it'll come right down here on your screen, and it'll also be saved on your desktop. So it's right here, and it's already an image. You don't have to do anything else. So that's the first way, Shift Command 4. Second is a screenshot copy. And I find this super useful as a graphic designer because this way you don't end up with 1,000 screenshots littering your desktop. To do this one, it's Shift Control Command and 4. You'll get the same cursor change, and then you can just screenshot whatever you want by drawing a box around it. But this one doesn't put the little image down here, and it also doesn't save it to your desktop. All it's done is take a copy of it. So now we can go to any program like Word or Illustrator. I'm going to create a new document and then just paste with Command V or Control V. And now we can move this around like a regular image. You can even start a new email and just paste it in there. Let me resize it down a little bit. So a copy screenshot is just useful in a lot of ways. Now I said three ways, but I'm actually going to show you four. You can actually take a screenshot of your whole screen by hitting Shift Command 3, and that just automatically takes a screenshot. You don't have to draw a rectangle around it. Now when we look at our desktop, we can see this one right here, and that is the entire screen. Now for the last way, let's say you want a screenshot of an entire web page. So I'm going to go out here to target.com, and whenever I get on this page, you can see we have a lot to scroll through. It's a really long page. So I wanted to show you a way to screenshot this whole page. Now, technically you could screenshot each section with the previous methods I showed you, but it's such a pain because you would have to piece them all together. With the way I'm going to show you, it can be just one image in one long page. So to do this, we need to go to our Chrome extensions. We'll have to download an extension to do this. So I'm going to click on these three dots and then choose More Tools and Extensions. Then I'll click on these three lines and I'll choose Open Chrome Web Store. The name of this extension is called Go Full Page. And this is it right here. So I'll click it and then Add to Chrome. And I'll add extension. And I'll close this. Now, if you're not seeing it up here right off the bat, you'll need to click on this little puzzle piece. And then you'll be able to see it in the list. Then you can choose this little pin icon and then it'll add it here. So let's go back to the target page, and I'm just going to click this Go Full Page icon. And then it'll capture this entire page. And when it's done, it'll open this screen. And we can download it in a few different ways. We can do a PDF, and we can also do a PNG. So I'm going to click the Download Image PNG button. I'll have to allow. Now this is going to go in my downloads. So I'm going to click this little caret right down here and choose Show in Finder. And now if I hit my space bar, I can preview this whole page. I can also drag it onto Chrome to open it as a web page and then just click on it and you can see it at full size. I also had to hit Command minus to zoom out a little bit. But this is just an image. This is not actually the web page itself. So Go Full Page extension is a really handy little clipper that can help you save a screenshot of an entire long web page. All right, I hope this video has helped you. If you liked it and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.